All right, boys and girls, it is time once again for the Guys Weekend Podcast. I am Josh Henning, along with, as always, this very, very frustrated and irritated Brandon Parks.
Yes. It seems like every time we go to do this podcast, something happens.
They're on to us. We're one step away from not having internet access in our household.
Yeah, which is funny because when I got onto my Spectrum app this morning to check to make sure that there wasn't an outage, which I knew there wasn't an outage because I was just on my laptop prior to hooking it up here. I also played video games yesterday. I was on my phone, so I knew the internet was working. I checked the app, and it goes, hey, do you want to install this profile for free public Wi-Fi because there's 500,000 hotspots and there's five really strong locations right next to you? And I'm like, I'm on to you, 5G. I'm on to you. So I installed that profile. Didn't help. Couldn't connect to any of those. I unplugged my router from the wall. I unplugged the modem. I unplugged the coaxial cable. I unplugged every cable downstairs that I could three times. Luckily, the third time, it worked. I don't understand why I'm having these issues. Everything was running perfectly just an hour and a half ago. Motherfuckers! Fuck you, Spectrum. Fuck you, Apple. Fuck you, Restream. Cocksuckers.
Ghost of Steve Jobs.
That's right. 90 seconds is up, bitches. Fuck cocksuckers. But whatever. We're here now. And we've got some things to discuss. I'm not sure what. My shitty fantasy football. That's terrible anyway. We're going to get Christmas trees next weekend. And the going rate for how much would you pay for a live tree, Josh?
I don't know. But I think tops, like 75.
Okay, well, the starting price at this tree farm is 80. So... I feel like...
Hey, you got any local Boy Scouts selling trees this year? We usually have them down here.
Oh, you know, I'm not sure. I don't know where the local... You know who I should ask about the Boy Scouts? Our very own. Magoo. Scouts Honor Magoo. From that one time he went backpacking in New Mexico 19 years ago.
Listen, the only tree that he knows where it's being sold.
Touche. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I wanted to do one of those ones where you go and you get like the whole thing. You get the bulb and all of that. And then you give it back to them and they replant it. Because they charge like $40 or whatever it is. And then you bring it back and they give you your money back. I'm like, wow.
Oh, it was like a...
It's like a rental.
Like going to get a propane tank.
Yeah. Yeah. Pretty much. And as long as you bring it back, they give you your money back. If you don't bring it back, then you have to find a place to plant the tree on your own, which that would be fine with me. Keep my $40 and let me just plant this tree in my backyard. I think that'd be cool. Mm-hmm. You know, next thing you know, I've got a whole, you know, shelter of pine trees growing in my backyard. Keep the neighbors out. Keep the gunshots down.
You don't want it to block your path to get. Oh,
never
there, though.
No. That'll stay readily accessible, and it's probably going to be put to use here next weekend, as Sober November draws to a close. The countdown begins.
You know, I never understood why they do Sober November. Like, it doesn't even rhyme. Why not Sober October?
Well. Tyson and I didn't do Sober October because of Guys Weekend.
Yeah.
So, and the Halloween party, which we were sick and didn't go for anyway. There's a lot going on. We narrowed it down to 2 months, November and February.
I did the one that's got 28 days.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to do it again in February just to, you know, I feel like giving my body a break every once and again is good, since I'm getting older now and I can no longer play video games for like 35 minutes without getting up to stretch. Like, my shoulder hurts. Mm-hmm. Like we were going through it last weekend, Magoo and I. Like every three matches we'd have to get up and walk around, high knees. Nobody likes a blood clot. So We had to move it around.
I think I'm developing carpal tunnel in my right arm. Like it's... I find now that when I'm sleeping and if I have my right arm at any kind of angle while I'm sleeping, I get this throbbing pain that shoots from my elbow down to my wrist into my fingers and my middle index and thumb go numb. And then when I go make a ball with my fist and keep like doing that, it feels like my ligaments in my arm are all fucking twisted around one another.
Same. So that happens here with me, but with my pinky and ring finger. I don't know. Me, you, and Magoo all have the same shoulder or elbow right hand injury. It has nothing to do with guys weekend.
No.
So I'm trying to narrow down what beer I'd like to drink first this coming weekend. We have our company Christmas party on Saturday, so I can't get, you know. All right, so I'm not on the clock, right? It's breakfast with Santa. It's at a local bar. They're doing like a breakfast buffet. The families are going to be there, you know. It's one of those things. Wear your Christmas PJs, et cetera, et cetera.
So I miss those like 1980s, 1990s corporate fucking holiday parties where they fucking you drank in the office. You know, you may or may not have seen John McClane.
Right.
You know, coming in, saving your asses. You know.
It's fantastic. So
office crushes fucking in the offices.
Yeah. Yeah. It's snowing indoors, you know?
Yeah.
Gone are those days. So Tice and I, since I work at the Dayhab, you know, I figured it was only right to show up for the Christmas party, even though I'm not working. So in the back of my mind, I'm like, well, if I get a little something in my glass while I'm there, I mean, I'm not technically working. Is that still a bad look? I feel like that's still a bad look. Like I shouldn't go in there right off the rip and be like, give me a JMO and ginger. Because
take the Yeti with you.
That's what I thought about
doing. Take the tumbler. Yeah.
That's what I thought about doing. Because I can't drink beer because they're going to be like, oh, you smell like beer. I feel like I like towards the end of it, it's like from like 9 to 11. So I'm like, okay, you know, like 10:30, motherfuckers are getting ready to roll out of there. You know, they've opened all their Christmas gifts. We're cleaning up.
You know what turns into my jam that like really, that you really can't smell it after a while, like on the breath and on the body or anything? I've gotten into White Russians.
The dudes drink. I don't know if I can. Isn't that rum chata?
So it's
heavy or half and half or whatever that shit is.
I think it's like Kahului.
Oh yeah. See, I feel like that's gonna make me vodka, coffee, liqueur, and cream. See, I don't like.
You don't like coffee.
No. Maybe I should just not. Not be that guy.
It's an elegant version of vodka and Red Bull.
I could just get an orange juice, do like a little screwdriver.
Yeah.
No, then I'll have heartburn all day. I don't want to do that. Mm. See, so I figured once with previous Christmas parties. At the end, once everybody's cleaning up, it was customary, although I didn't get to partake because I was technically on the clock. Once everybody started going out of there, the kitchen help, so basically the people higher up than I, would go into the kitchen and dig into their little stash of beers and seltzers and drink them in the back as the party was winding down. So I'm kind of wondering that if maybe this party winds down, if we're going to stay for a cocktail. I don't know. But we're having the first board game night of the season next weekend. So I'm going to try not to get too sloshy for that. I think I'm aiming for a buzzed by 5 o'clock, dinner at 6:30, bed by 9 kind of deal. I'm pretty sure Maggie is preparing for the wheels to fall off. And, you know, she, and I quote yesterday, was giving Tice shit.
Are you going to make up for the past 30 days that you weren't drinking and try to play catch up all in one day because it's party time?
I'm like,
You know, I'd like to be the one that gives Maggie shit on this, but you know, she kind of has a point.
Oh, I agree. I yes.
If there's anybody that knows you guys,
oh yeah,
as good as I do, then it's probably her. And she knows exactly what you're gonna do.
Yeah, so I'm hoping that's not the case. It probably will be. I'll be hungover as fuck for the next podcast. Shit, because I'll have to do that before we go. We have to leave here by, as long as my internet works. We have to leave here at like 9. It's in Ravenna, so it's Kent. It's like 45 minutes from here. More than likely what will happen is Tyson will end up getting schlossed, staying the night, and then he'll just roll with us up there, so. Which I invited Mike and Eric. I don't know if they're going to come down. Either way, they could do the same thing. So,
lunch at a lizard.
Yeah. No, we're going to Mike's place, actually. Oh. Have you gone to Mike's place with us? It's a fantastic joint. They serve PBRs in 16-ounce cans for $2. I can't be getting sloppy because I have to drive. But I will be having a beer with lunch. Actually, my plan was to – I found my thermos the other day, and I want to make some hot apple cider and take it with us because I think it's going to be cold in the 40s and rainy. And, you know, what better thing to warm the soul than just hot rum in the belly, you know?
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to get a PBR ugly sweater for Christmas.
Speaking of which, Brad sent me a Christmas sweater.
We need to look up to see who makes ugly sweaters and get a GWP ugly sweater made.
Oh man, I should really look into making our little merch site. So I'm not just I actually have a window open right now. Who makes custom? I hope that it comes sleeveless because that's what I want. So I showed we were talking about the Christmas party and they want us to wear Christmas pajamas and I'm like, I really don't have any Christmas pajamas, but first website that pops up, customize your own. The ugly sweater company. So I'm like, hey, can I wear what I wore a few years ago to the party? And I showed the big boss the picture of me with the green sweater with the titty cut out and it had the little Rudolph nose on my nipple and the eyes and the antlers. He goes, what the fuck is wrong with you? And I'm like, well, you know, he's like, no, you can't wear that. I'm like, damn. Oh, we can. Is this just, holy shit. Okay. $36 a sweater. Oh, wait a minute. I lied. Full custom knit. I don't know what the difference is. Sublaminated. Oh, like a regular sweatshirt. Custom poly knit. Holy shit. This is a 70 to 80 calendar day lead time. So we'd have it for next year.
So we need to do this in like the summer next year.
Yeah, well, this one's a full knit. That's probably why. Like these other ones, like the partial custom poly knit, which I don't know exactly what is. It's a 2 to 5 day business time. Business lead. Which those are actually kind of cool. I'm not gonna lie. Oh, they do scarves too.
Which one do you want? I'm on uglychristmassweater.com.
Okay. So
and it looks sweaters. Like they have ships in 2 business days. They do pajamas and everything too.
Oh, these are the sweaters that were featured on the Kelly and Ryan Seacrest show.
Oh. That's probably why they're fucking backed up.
Coors. Who gets Uber on a Christmas sweater? What a loser.
Did we talk about this on a previous podcast? You know Uber does dispatches trucking now?
Yes. That's
fucking insane.
It is wild.
Those drivers probably get like 15 cents a mile after all the fees are taken out.
Probably. What is five-hour energy on a unicorn?
These are a little bit more expensive.
Okay. This one says we help people.
$65 for a knit.
If it's a quality sweater. I guess I don't know what the. Okay, so that's a sweatshirt. Poly knit sweaters? What's the fucking difference here? Oh, they're just like, oh, these would kind of work. There's four patterns. Let's see if I can copy this and send it to you. See if that link works that I just sent you there. Those are just kind of blasé, blasé. Not very, you know, GWP-ish. It would work, though. I mean, that top left one with the Christmas trees on it isn't bad. Okay, get off my screen now, bitch. They make slides? Oh. We could get sandals with GWP. Oh, my God. This is great. Socks. Underwear. Oh, I got to have some underwear. What can we choose from here? Oh, that's cool. All right. So, yeah. I don't know what Brad sent me, but he sent it. Oh, you know what? He sent those to Sammy, Chuck and Sam's house. And those turds just moved. So, I'll have a Christmas sweater by this time next year. Okay, so that's doable. GWP, man, Christmas sweaters. Oh, we're just going to be just swagged out. I mean, the drip don't stop, baby. I like it. Yeah, what else could we get done? I got that post-nasal drip. It's pretty bad.
Tis the season.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of drip, I woke up this morning to the sound of pouring rain. The wind would whisper, and wait. I'm off topic there. But I did wake up to the sound of pouring rain, and I heard this very distinct drip. It's finally happened. The roof is leaking. I noticed the stain on my ceiling got a little larger over the past couple months, and I'm like, I wonder. And this morning it was drip, drip, dripping on the floor. So that was fantastic to wake up to, then to sit down and then have my laptop not work. And really makes you want to drink, you know?
Yeah.
But
you know what sucks too with inflation and stuff? Because your roof coverage is significantly less than mine, but you're probably going to end up spending as much as I did.
Yep.
2-3 years ago.
Well, I'm hoping that when we have storm season, it just wrecks our roof, and we can take solace in our bean camper, and do that, dude. We got the tent that we ordered for camping this year. This thing is massive. Like, it's like stupid. We have no business needing a tent this big. You could easily fit like it's so think of when we go to Berlin and we use both screen tents on two, like when we used to do the draft and make the screen tents, it's about that big. It's massive. Like, you could probably fit 10 people in this thing. Easy. Like, we have a bedroom. We have a sitting area. We could have a small kitchen. Like, it's stupid big. I could park the Grom in there and the four-wheeler and my lawnmower. It's stupid, but I like it. It'll do.
Did they not have a like a black option? I mean, if we're going to go like logo, I want to go the most like fucking gaudy at that point. Like, if they don't have black, I want it to be like extremely gaudy. Like, I'll go the green, white, and red option on there.
Yeah, I mean, if it's full knit, I think we have up to six colors. Six color maximum. Made in China, small upcharge for full USA made. Jesus.
Small upcharge. That's because everybody down here is making minimum $18 an hour. So
yeah. Oh, they have a sweater vest option.
Leave it over at China. They're all making like 80 cents an hour.
Handful of rice a day.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm getting a sweater vest. Yeah, got to do it. So we could do six. Can we... please enter a number greater than or equal to 25. Yikes.
So you got to buy in bulk?
Looking for less? Order now on our consumer site. Okay. Let's see what we got here. Oh. You know what? That's probably why it was fucking 6 months. Oh, yeah. This ships in 24 hours. Custom family Christmas sweater? Yeah, that's kind of lame. Custom all over print sweater. Oh yeah, that's what we want. Oh, it's discontinued for retail customers. Son of a bitch. We have to do wholesale. All right, we need 23 other people that want a sweater.
Hey, damn. We buy in bulk, and it'll end up being cheaper for everybody.
It's true. All right, so I don't want a poly one. I want an actual sweater. Oh, these are just the lame. It's just like the pre-made ones with the two styles. One's green with Christmas trees. One's with, it says your name, family Christmas.
I want a sweater and a blazer.
Oh, that's fantastic. We should get custom blazers made, and then the inside stitching says GWP.
Oh yeah, the whole like line. in a pattern.
Yeah,
like it's like a in each diamond in the quilt inside.
Yeah, custom blazers. Stupid. No, those are shoes. I don't want that. Oh, no. Indochino. I can already tell this is going to be expensive. God dang. 360. I'm good, bro. I'm never going to wear it that many times that I need to do that. This is velvet. A velvet burgundy dinner jacket. Wow.
Can we get like, I want it like a smoking
jacket. Smoking jacket. Yeah, yeah. Like a Hugh Hefner kind of deal. I mean, they have them on here. Listen, this is too nice for me to be wearing around with like my gut hanging out and fucking beer stains on and smelling like cigars. Can't be doing that.
We could do, let's do like the, like 1979, like corduroy fucking blazer.
Retro smoking jackets. What we should do is just start hitting up like Goodwill. Oh my God, this is awesome. All right. I want one of these. What size is it coming? It's $30. Oh man. I'm sending you the link, Josh. This is pretty cool. I wish it came in a different color though. It's kind of dope. We could wear them around. Oh, dude, we could wear them around at the cabin.
Just shit. Just wear guys weekend. Everybody's just wearing smoking jackets.
Yes, I like it. That's kind of cool. I like that one. Oh, there it is. The historical size robe length smoking jacket. Black with burgundy velvet. This dude's Russian, so you know it's cool.
Oh, that is sweet. It's only,
that is pretty cool.
Is that price right?
Yeah, and it's like $10 for shipping.
Go up by size.
I didn't think so. No, because I clicked on mine.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Right? I think that's worth it.
I do, too. However, I can't remember the last time I had my shoulders measured. I don't know, or my chest measured. I think I'm a little bigger than a 44, so I don't think that's going to work. This one I found is a little bit more expensive, but it's a vintage smoking robe. Man, I would wear this more often.
See if, see if I can get the screen share to work so we can show the fans what we're looking at.
Yeah, there we go.
Look at that right there. That's what we're looking to do.
I can't see anything on your screen. It's not popping up on my side.
It's not.
Oh, wait. No. Do we need three windows? Whoa. That was not right.
No, it won't let me share it.
Damn, those bastards. Listen, this guy's wearing the slacks and the shoes. Since he was a baby, my grandson has always stripped down, curled up in a blanket, and claimed his corner of my couch. It was fine when he was little, but he is a teenager now. When I saw this, I knew it was perfect for him. He has always had a love for super soft, and this is a way beyond that. When I showed my husband and he tried it on, he immediately asked for one himself. The quality and the workmanship and the materials are out of this world. Wow. Hey, we could get a cotton twill walking skirt. I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna tell Maggie I want this for Christmas. Fetch me my smoking jacket, woman.
I don't know. I like the blazer smoking jacket a lot better than the robe.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, this is kind of dope. Send you this one here. This is real fancy right here. Man, I wish you guys could see this. You guys are missing out. Let's see, smoking jackets. I smoked two cigars yesterday sober. That was different. It wasn't horrible. Oh, they have custom made with initials on them. Oh, man. Evening gown, robe, dinner coat. Oh, my goodness. I think Magoo already has one. It might just be a robe. He says he likes to walk around in the buff just wearing his robe, so I'm assuming he probably has one. So that purple and gold one's kind of dope. Oh, boy. Smoking jacket.
Oh, they got different patterns on here.
I know. That's super cool.
Gee, oh, I like the red one. I like the blood red one on here. There's one that is like half and half. Like half is black, half is gold.
That's nice. There's so many cool ones on here. Oh, black velvet and silk. Huh. Put it on my nipples. Hey, I don't think $100 is too much. Whoa. Wait a minute. Green collar. Oh, they have a purple collar. Let me see that. No. Does it come with the pocket square? I hope. Man, wouldn't that be cool if it came with like a little cigar holder? That'd be sweet. I feel like I should smoke a pipe if I'm doing that. And not a crack pipe, you know? Okay. This is cool. All right. So yeah, smoking jackets are a thing. And I think we should look more into those.
Show the fans on what we're looking at. Right there. Look at that bad boy.
Oh yeah. That is just, that's pure sex right there. Whew. I like it.
That's the party we need to have. Everybody, all the guys show up in a smoking jacket. Like, yeah. Like a gaudy one. It has to be a gaudy smoking jacket.
Yeah. I like it. Dress shoes, slacks. Party.
That'd be a great party.
It's almost like a Gatsby party.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, but like Gatsby's in Canton, Ohio.
Yeah.
It's just trash. I like it.
Oh, man. The possibilities we could have.
It's just something super fun for the whole family.
Brought to you by GWP.
That's right.
Make it an annual event. The go-to gala.
Oh.
Of the year.
Yes. Yes. It's like a... when would we do it?
Has to be in the winter sometime.
When do they have the Met Gala? That's usually like in the spring or something, right?
It's like, yeah.
I want it to be like a competition for that. Except it's not going to be like everybody wearing like weird shit. I want it to be the most hillbilly shit people wear to this event, and like the art and shit at the gala is all like fucking
track macaroni and
yeah hay, pictures of hay and shit like that.
Macaroni pictures. finger painting.
What's with the gluing the popsicle sticks together and shit like
fucking stacking up beer cans into different things. Oh, like the old school airplanes that you used to cut out of like cans and shit.
Yeah.
I got a bunch of that in the basement.
Paper airplanes.
Yes. May 2nd is the Met Gala. It was this past year. An anthology of fashion. And I mean, I think the GWP Gala is going to be leaps and bounds better.
No guaranteed.
We should have an annual meetup. And just hype it up.
Oh, God.
For the listeners out there, for all you dedicated 7 people, we appreciate it.
It's going to be $400 a ticket or or 230 racks of Busch Light.
Yeah, we're all just going to get housed. It's great.
Per person.
And you have to be wearing a smoking jacket.
And even if you buy the ticket to get in,
yep.
No entry will not be allowed until you do a beer bong.
Even better. Because we're trying to be sloppy. Man, it'd be great. A photo booth. We could make one of those.
Oh, yeah.
Have you seen those new things they do at weddings? Where you stand on the platform and they like whip the phone around you in 360 degrees. It's on like a tripod. It's not really like a tripod mount, but it's like you stand on a circle and then they have like a selfie stick attached to the circle. And then they put the phone there and they hit record and they just spinning it around you. And it's kind of like a, you know, they slow it down in slow motion and it's kind of like, pose. Do you weird? That'd be cool to have. I don't even know what those are called. Spinning. Selfie booth. Oh, yeah. Wow.
So I told the wife what would be cool to have for the basement down here is a record player.
Yeah.
But play some old school like 70s, 80s rock music down here.
Yeah. I looked into a couple of them. I found a few that would work with my Sonos speakers too.
Ooh.
And I was like, that'd be interesting. See, now I just want to light up a cigar up here and listen to old music. Open my window, get rid of the pee smell.
That's what we would do at the GWP Gala. All the music would be played on a record player.
Yeah, but we can't drink good scotch.
That's like gotta be
old Dan Tucker. Brett and Amanda and Pam know exactly what I'm talking about. Fantastic stuff. It's like $6.99 a bottle. You could run a lawnmower off of it. It's good for removing stains. You drink enough of it and you'll go blind. I feel like that's the tagline of GWP. That's the liquor, the brown liquor of GWP is old Dan Tucker. And now I need old Dan Tucker, a smoking jacket, and a cigar.
Mm-hmm.
How pissed do you think Maggie would get if she just smelled a cigar from up here? It probably wouldn't be too bad if I left the door shut down there and I just opened the window.
No, yeah, she won't. She won't smell. By the time she get like the only thing that would if she opens that door and starts coming upstairs, you know, that's when.
Well, yeah, right. The odds of that happening are slim to none. So I have a fan up here. I could just plug the fan in right here and just blow this way across me out the window.
Yeah.
Man, it's doable. Might do that today.
Just build in an exhaust fan out of the window. Get one of those window fan units.
Yeah.
Turn it around.
Yeah.
That's what we used to do back in the day.
It's just fucking hazy as shit up here. I'd be going to work, like, why do you smell like smoke? Oh, you know what I could do? I could like section off part of the, like this half of the room, so like the rest of the stuff doesn't stink. You know, like Magoo used to do with his hot box. He used to have this, I think it was like a refrigerator box. So it was, you know, like 5 foot tall or whatever. And in his living room, which is about the size of, I don't know, the upstairs here, like half of the upstairs, he would shut that door and he would put blankets underneath there, like at the bottom of the door. And then he would sit inside of this refrigerator box with the top shut and stuff on top of it. And he would just hot box this box. And you just hear me there. And it's just, you know, smoke rolling out of there. And he's just like, wow, this is great. Just a lot of just ridiculous shit back in the Bananarama days.
That's a appliance box fort building taken to another level.
Oh yeah. And he kept it. Like it was a staple of the living room. Like it was behind the couch for the longest time, or in the closet. It was one of the two, but he would bust it out for big occasions. It was great.
You can tell as Magoo gets older, his lung capacity is going down because he's coughing a lot when he's trying to hit the Chiba, you know?
Yeah. Well, he's moved on from flour to wax now. So he should probably take a tea break. Honestly, I think that would do him well. Cause he's smoking quite a bit of the devil's lettuce and, it's, yeah, I think if he even just took like a week break, it would help. But, you know, to each their own, I suppose. That's Magoo.
that's what Magoo in Paradise, that's how it always ends. That's Magoo.
Oh, I want like a, we need a soundboard. Alex was talking about that. We definitely need a soundboard.
I thought about it, you know, because they're fairly inexpensive on Amazon.
Oh man, we could get his laughs.
Oh boy, just record them over the span of like four or five guys' weekends. Just record them over a year.
Yeah, it'd be. Oh my god.
The problem is he's to the point where he tries not to laugh.
And that's when we get him like. Like, you know, when he's gone real far, he tries real hard not to do it, and then we just we double down on it. He goes right to it.
I feel like we're at a point where we have to do like physical harm to our bodies to get him to go.
Yeah. Oh, it's only like $50.
Yeah. You know, they have different sizes, different specs on them. You know, at the most it's like $100. They go up like $10 or $15 for every upgrade, depending on what you want.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, it's got a voice changer on it. Oh,
nah, that'd be great for the confessionals.
Yeah, yeah. And when Hat Marge is on there and he has to,
yeah,
you know, they're on a cruise right now, by the way. They made me the emergency contact number. My sister's like, hey, if you get a call from a random number this week, please answer it because it's probably us and something's wrong. And I'm like, oh, okay. I think they're, I don't know where they're going. Aruba?
They were down in Florida, right?
Yeah, that's they were Viva a la Miami. Yeah. I don't remember where they said they went. It's three places, it's a week long.
You know, nobody knows who Hat Marger is on this on the picture in the background. We should start blurring out his face because.
Yeah, we should. That'd be great. And then have him talking to the voice changer every time he's on the podcast now.
Yeah.
To protect his identity.
Oh shit. The only thing is I don't know how that works. I don't know how well that works if you're in
recording
different areas. Like, I think the soundboard only works for like the person who's physically with it.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's fair. I'm sure there's a free one online. I'm actually
surprised Restream doesn't have that shit. They got everything else on here.
Well, that was Obi-Wan Kenobi. Taco Bell bong. See, if I could get this to play through the show, can I add? Oh, we're gonna have to figure that out. How we add other audio. Whoa. Oh my god. That was very loud and unpleasant. whoa, I don't want to, no, stop playing. Oh, this is dumb. Why did I get on here? Friday. Oh, okay, stop. Oh my god, that was terrible. All right, yeah, we're gonna have to figure out how to do this. How to? No. Oh, you could do a soundboard for OBS. Oh yeah. All right. I'll look into that.
There's probably a lot of shit we can use in OBS that we don't fucking even.
Oh, I'm sure.
Comprehend at this point.
Yeah.
So how was Thanksgiving?
Oh, it was well. I ate a lot of turkey and mashed potatoes stuffing. I won $1 on a game that we played at. Maggie's side of the family stole it from a small child. So, you know, just fuck them kids. How was it on your end?
Same. A lot of turkey, a lot of mashed potatoes. We had some ribs.
Ooh.
Which was really good.
Well, Thanksgiving Day rib action. I like it.
Great bark on them.
Even better. We just had, yesterday was the Ohio State-Michigan game. And
yeah, Ohio State got spanked.
They did. We had deep fried turkey. It was fantastic. Oh, and then there were these little peanut butter cookies there. These peanut butter cookies were peanut butter chocolate chip cookies were fantastic. And Katie made a buckeye dip, to which I doubled up and made like a double peanut butter chocolate chip extravaganza. It was delicious.
I gotta spend money on a new turkey fryer.
The one that they used there was a Loco turkey fryer. It was like $100.
I think. Oh, you know what? That might have been what they had at Walmart. I think Walmart had them for like $75 this weekend.
Probably. I'm still clicking random noises here. That one was an air horn. It says get fucked. that was awesome. It was a good time I had by all. I left early yesterday to come check on the dogs and played Call of Duty and took a nap. And then went back to pick up Maggie, who was mixing Busch Light Apple and Jack Fire in like full blown pint glasses. And then she mixed a couple with Bud Light Seltzers, came out with like a whole apple line. Different like caramel apple, candy apple, whatever, Adam's apple. And that was just what they tasted like, I guess. And she was mixing Jack Fire with that. I'm like, yeah, you know what? You guys can just, you can deal with her. I'm going to go home. And she's like, well, why are you leaving? I'm like, I'll be back. That was the screaming goat. That was awesome. Wrestling bell. That's kind of cool. Man, we got to figure out how to get this on here. Big butt woman farts. Oh, that's great. In the arms of the angel. That's perfect. Oh my! I'm gonna send you this link because this one's great. We could have played this when Logan was on here. Which, by the way, I haven't seen Logan in a hot minute. He's living his best life. Doesn't want to come to another guy's waking because he didn't have fun. So
it's not his scene.
Yeah, whatever. If he would have had his car up there, he might have made it.
Instead, so could,
you know. I think Jacob said he'd come back.
He wants to
get... You just went all robot-y on me there. Oh no, are we about to lose it?
God damn it.
Oh, you're getting real grainy. Yeah, I can hear you. Hold on. Boy.
Let me how about now?
I can, yes. It's lagging a bit, but
am I good?
Yeah.
All right. It all started when I tried opening that link you sent me.
Yeah. That don't happen. Afro Circus. That. Yes. That's fantastic.
What I was saying was, are there any other dudes that Logan wants to invite that he hasn't gotten the five knuckle shuffle from?
No, the list of his male friends that have seen in or touched, licked, or had on their face his male appendage is pretty filled out. There's not many left that haven't. So, we'll see if he might come back up to a summer one. We'll see. Probably not though. He'll get bored of being in the house with his old lady all winter and be like, fuck, I need out of here. But we'll see. Okay, I wish I could just stop them. Oh. Nope, that doesn't stop them. It will not stop. Oh my god. Not gonna lie, I kind of like this one. It's the party button. It's like almost to the bottom of the page. It's a teal one. When that kicks in, it's pretty cool. Oh, they got the Quagmire Giggity on here. Nice. Black people react. Heyo. Oh, it's them yelling. Man, I wish. All right, yeah. it's so ridiculous. We have to get this onto the show because this would be fantastic. Oh my god, this is gonna be so great. Peter Parker pizza time.
Should be able to
add it as like
add a source and restream.
Virtual background, audio. No. What if we added like a third person and that person's audio was just...
Cut the camera just and leave the audio?
Yeah. That might work. Oh my god, there's so many on here. This is great. Watch out intro for John Cena? Yeah. Hakuna Matata? Holy fucking shit, it's a what? That's kind of cool. We have to do this. So what should my first drink be on December 1st? I am off at 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I thought about just coming straight home, you know, and saving it for Saturday or Sunday when we go to get the tree. But I just so happened to pass a local drinkery. And since it's the first of the month, they get the new beer list in, which will most likely be chock full of Christmas beers.
Oh, what's that? What's that Christmas beer that Magoo likes?
Regular Christmas ale, yeah.
Yeah. Christmas ale, yeah.
He gets a little loosey goosey on that.
Should probably start off with that.
It's not a bad idea.
Tis the season, you know?
Tis the season to be sloppy drunk. Yeah. Schmandon's back, baby.
Schmandon went on a 30-day hiatus.
Yeah, he was banned he was banned IRL. Which my Facebook is I say this now, I'm going to hop on here and they're going to fucking ding me again. Let me see. I'm pretty sure all my restrictions have been lifted. Yeah. So how long before I go back? Who knows? Probably a week. Probably next Monday. I'll end up posting some stupid shit. Oh, no. I have the live option back on here. Can I really go live right now? Oh, we're trying it out right now.
Oh, God.
Wow. The Zuckerberg has decided to let me go live again.
Zuck, you fucked up.
He did. As we're recording the Guys Weekend podcast, I'm also live. So this is an option, Josh. We might be live Saturday night. And that's when the ban will happen. That's when I'll get slammed again with, you're not allowed to post that on Facebook. I don't know what happens after 60 days. Do you think they go to 90 days? It's got to be something. I mean,
you're on an 875-day ban.
I wonder how long it takes to get like a perma ban. Oof. I've got to be getting close. But I look at the same time. There's people that are worse off than me on Facebook.
Listen, the stuff you've posted, like there's one that you've even said, yeah, I probably should have got slap on the wrist. Well, every other one other than that probably was not
no
a bannable offense. No.
It's Zuckerberg doesn't like banning me. What's up, Eric? I finally got the ability to go back live and we're recording the podcast. Hey, just to
you know who I guarantee you doesn't get banned? The people from the third world countries that keep going on these podcast groups that keep posting fucking a horse penis going in a vagina.
They can post horse penises into vaginas. Oh, here comes the ban. Yeah. Those Saudi Arabian princes that keep emailing me about, hey, we have your money here and we'd like you to respond back.
Brandon's Facebook Live freedom only lasts about 40 seconds.
Yeah, I was going to say, I've only been live now for like 2 minutes, and it's the band's coming. I can feel the band hammer being swung. So it was real, Facebook. Stick to it and keep watching. Schmandon makes his triumphant return this Saturday, December 3rd, 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So.
Well, let's face it, you're going to get the ban before then. They've already got you in the crosshairs. Schmand is not even going to make it this Saturday.
That's true. Zuckerberg's waiting. Him and his group of goons are watching the Facebook feed to make sure that I'm not doing anything stupid.
You're just waiting. A picture of you without your shirt on. It's been banned.
I'm going to keep the shirt on Facebook Live because I feel like that's going to prolong my longevity of being able to go live again on Facebook. Ladies and gentlemen, Chuck Schoenfeld has joined the live. We need you on the podcast, Charles. But yeah, so I'm going to wrap up the podcast. Stay tuned for Schmandon back on tour, December 3rd, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Schmandon's reunion tour.
The reunion tour. The band's getting back together. Schmandin and Schmeiss will be together. And that will probably be the last time I get to go live for the rest of the year. So enjoy it. I'll make it hopefully worth it. And we will enjoy it while it lasts. Oh, boy.
I can't wait.
It's going to be something. Look at that. Live
guys and gals. What?
Seven people. Almost 10 people watching. See, I got to give the people what they want, Josh. Yeah. I got to do it.
So give you something to look forward to Saturday, December 3rd. Live from
Chateau de Parks.
Scanton, Ohio.
Yeah. Yeah. It's going to be real. SDHI is making its winter debut.
So for Brandon Parks, I am Josh Tenney. This was the Guys Weekend Podcast. Good night.
Gonna be hungover.